Nearly 4 million miles of interstates, highways, and local roads allow U.S. drivers to connect from their driveways to their destinations. The construction, rehabilitation, operations, and preservation of highways are supported financially by the Federal Aid Highway Program. State departments of transportation demonstrate responsible stewardship of public funds by ensuring pavements reach their expected service lives. Consistent quality materials can improve long-term project performance. Quality assurance and materials acceptance plans are the backbone of successful highway construction projects. Random sampling and sample security are two key activities that support the construction of a high-quality, low-variability product that will stand the test of time. Quality assurance responsibilities are shared by the contractor and the agency to achieve a project's contracted level of quality. There are six elements which define a robust state DOT quality assurance program, which are considered throughout the life of a project. Four elements most directly address sources of sampling and testing variability, including independent assurance, technician qualification and certification, laboratory accreditation and qualification, and materials testing dispute resolution. Reducing variability is important to enable appropriate decision-making in the other two elements, contractor quality control and agency acceptance. Random sampling and sample security are primary components of the quality assurance process. A quality characteristic is a specific characteristic of a unit or product that is measured to determine conformance with a given requirement. Materials quality specifications are a set of various constituent characteristics for a specific product, such as aggregates, asphalt mixtures, or Portland cement concrete. Acceptance testing is used to verify that product complies with state DOT specific requirements. Agencies must be able to provide evidence to support proper payment consistent with the applicable federal aid project requirements. Variability is inherent in all construction materials and products, including those used in highway construction. It's important for both contractor and agency personnel to understand what's being measured and recognize the influence of different sources of variability on the measurement. When variability is low, a process is in control, and the contractor is capable of producing a quality end product. If variability is high, issues can arise that cause a product not to meet specifications or result in an inconsistent product being constructed.
Construction and materials variability can be grouped into four categories: materials, process, sampling, and testing. These sources of variability combine to form the composite variability for a construction process. Steps can be taken to reduce variability in a process. Variability can be assessed using statistical methods such as sample means, standard deviation, and confidence intervals.
Agencies are required to have a quality assurance program approved by FHWA that includes a frequency guide schedule, also called a sampling plan. A sampling plan should be developed to guide the process to obtain measurements for each quality characteristic. When developing a sampling plan, the factors that should be considered are the construction material or process of interest, the experience of personnel performing the sampling, safety, risk tolerance, and the potential for the process to change, and the impacts to the overall quality and long-term performance of the project. Intervals such as the quantity of material produced, the number of loads, or the number of hours of production can be used to establish the number and frequency of sampling and testing. To support statistical approaches, a sampling plan should be useful and comprehensive, provide reliable results, include activities that can be readily performed safely and efficiently, and provide results that are accurately interpreted and used. Several approaches exist for acquiring both quality control, or QC, and acceptance samples. Approaches can generally be categorized into random sampling, and biased or selective sampling. Random sampling is a common approach which represents the entire output over a defined lot or sublot. Each portion of material has an equal probability of being selected for sampling and testing using random numbers.
A simple random sampling approach can result in samples being taken from a certain area of a lot which may not represent the entire output. However, in stratified random sampling approaches, lots are divided into sublots and sample locations are then randomly determined within each sublot. The incremental process of stratified random sampling is ongoing throughout the production or delivery process to properly represent the material and capture both the material and process variability.
For both QC and acceptance samples, random sampling is critical to ensure the integrity of the acceptance decision. Using separate random numbers to identify the locations of both QC and acceptance samples keeps them independent. This approach ensures that these samples are taken independently and ultimately supports acceptance of a quality project that meets agency requirements.
Sampling concrete from a truck is a case where only a single variable of interest exists. In this case, only one random number is required to be generated. Alternatively, sampling across a paved area with both X and Y axes requires the generation of two random numbers, which identify the station and offset at which the sample is taken. Random number generation can often use tables, random number generation software, or an online random number generator.
Sample security practices are essential to ensure that fraud, abuse, and/or negligence do not jeopardize an agency's ability to procure and receive materials and construction products that meet specifications. The integrity of a sample should be maintained during collection, storage, and transport to ensure it is representative of the quality of the material on the project. All parties need to adhere to appropriate storage practices, including curing and other environmental conditioning, and appropriate transport provisions to provide a representative sample, maintain sample integrity, and minimize investigations.
To ensure the integrity of the sampling program, security measures should be used to prevent tampering. Appropriate forms and procedures to track the chain of custody and transfer information between parties should also be implemented. These measures provide confidence to the agency that the samples are secure and delivered in a timely manner. Tamper-evident devices include security tape with a unique number every 12 inches so that the number is included in the sample documentation. And security seals such as numbered zip tie locks on specimen transport cases. Security devices can be paired with technologies such as barcodes and other means to transfer documentation. Lab staff should check the documentation comparing to the security device to verify compliance. For concrete cylinders, controlling moisture loss and maintaining appropriate temperature control is critical during early stages to ensure concrete cylinder strength test results reflect the appropriate strength. Approved curing containers should be used and provisions implemented to maintain the required temperatures. To prevent tampering and theft, on-site curing containers should be clearly marked and secured. These are just a few examples of effective sample security measures that may be used by agencies and contractors.
Quality consistent materials and construction can increase the service life of a project and reduce the need for maintenance and rehabilitation activities. Agencies can use specifications and standards that encourage and reward the contractor for providing a consistent product. Quality characteristics are specified and measured to determine conformance with state DOT requirements. For each quality characteristic, a sampling plan is used to support QC and acceptance. Sampling and testing assist agencies and contractors in understanding variability in materials and products. The information provided supports quality control and the owner's acceptance decision. Random sampling is crucial to safeguarding the value of data obtained as part of QA programs. Security practices for samples implemented by agencies should prevent fraud, abuse, or negligence from impacting the integrity of the acceptance decision. Random sampling and sample security are important aspects of ensuring that the sampling and testing results accurately represent the materials on each project. Understanding and incorporating recommended random sampling approaches and implementing sampling security measures are two significant steps to toward an accepted construction project that meets QA goals and provides its expected service lifetime.